One of the things that you brought up in the trialogues I thought was particularly interesting and really resonated with me was you were talking about how children in New York City are afraid of monsters. Like, it's a natural inclination for children to be afraid of things in the dark with large teeth that are going to eat you. Mm. And that this goes back to the time where we were, you know, regularly predators took babies. They, like big cats or, you know, monsters, as it were, in the night would steal people, would eat people, would prey on human beings. That it makes sense that these children have this intuitive instinct built into their genetics or whatever it is.
Well, exactly. I mean, the standard sort of picture of the human prehistoric past is man the hunter striding out onto the savannas of Africa and stuff. But it was much more, I think, the case man the hunted. I mean, humans are particularly defenseless against big predators. And until recent times, were very vulnerable to them, like tigers. In India, during the under the British rule, even as late as the 1940s, there were thousands of people a year killed by man-eating tigers. And they usually go for the most vulnerable. I mean, when predators are working in Africa, when lions are attacking herds of antelope or something, they go for the old and the sick, or they go for the young, because they're the ones that are the most vulnerable. So probably over huge amounts of human history, young children had indeed been eaten by predators. These were the most realistic fears for huge periods of human history. And so I think it's fascinating that young children have these nightmares. The study in New York looked at the nightmares of young children. Nearly all of them were about being chased by monsters or scary animals. And of course, we feed this imagination in children through fairy tales. Think of Grimm's fairy tales, you know, like Little Red Riding Hood, where there's the big bad wolf, you know, that is going to eat up Little Red Riding Hood. There's so many stories in fairy tales of wolves that could eat children. And although nowadays the image of wolves has been sanitized and we're told they're basically furry, loving creatures, etc., they are predators, and if they get the chance in the past, I think they did eat children sometimes.
Not just in the past, it's in the present, if they have the right numbers.
Mm.
Wolves are dangerous. They're very tricky animals. It's just we eradicated them to very low numbers, and then when the numbers start to build up again, they start getting more and more dangerous again.
Well, I've seen this myself. We spend our summers on a remote island in British Columbia, Cortez Island, BC. And about 10 years ago, the wolves came back. They swam from other islands. And at first, most people there are sort of liberal kind of people. They thought it was great wildlife returns, etc. But these wolves became increasingly bold. And our family owns some land up there. We have a forest. We don't have a house. We just have forest land. And my sons were there on our land. They'd been sleeping out when a big wolf suddenly appeared and looked very, very threatening. And they'd been told, don't run if you see a wolf. So they stood there and they faced it. And then this wolf sort of puffed up its fur and charged them, and it stopped a few yards away. And they backed off slowly. They ran when they got round the corner. But this wolf was clearly threatening, very, very scary. If there hadn't been a pushback from the people on the island, they would have got increasingly bold.
Yeah, there's an issue that's going on right now where people are resisting the idea of hunting wolves because they've reintroduced wolves to a lot of the Western United States.
Well, given all this background, I think it's so fascinating that for young children, especially urban young children who've actually never seen a wolf in their life or any other scary animal, these are the things that haunt their nightmares, and I think this is part of a kind of collective memory.